I've had a few viral videos, but there's a few editing secrets behind their success. And well, today I'll tell you exactly how I did it using Adobe Premiere Pro. First and foremost, all my top performing videos are consistently paced. If you watch them, the story moves scenes and events pretty timely, and there's not too many moments that are dragged out or too long. Specifically, in editing terms, I really take a look over my timeline and I use the delete button, but it is one of the most powerful tools in editing. But overall, it's really important just to watch the video through multiple times to just see if there's moments that are boring. It's not a recipe for success if parts of your video are boring, especially on YouTube. Additionally, I color code my timeline for different scenes by highlighting a certain part. You can do this by right clicking and choosing your desired color. Number two, match cuts. Let's take a look into the intro of the world's tallest man video I made that has over 7 million views. The world's tallest man. So, what I did there was a match cut, and that just grabbed the viewer's attention and started off the video on the right foot. I did this effect by grabbing multiple similar looking clips of the world's tallest man, and then I lined them up using keyframes, and I also changed the opacity so I could kind of see all of them all at the same time. I pretty much went through every single clip and made sure it looked the exact same. Then I nested them all together. I added Gaussian blur, and I used the oval tool to make it focused on him. Then I inverted the mask, and then I feathered the shot so it looked smooth. It sounds like a lot, so maybe go through those steps kind of slowly. And then I added text and sound. You might be thinking this is a lot of work for an intro, but this is the most important part of a viral video. In my opinion, if you put an effect like this or some type of high-level editing in the beginning of your video, it honestly tells the viewers that the video is going to be high quality and ultimately helps build trust with the viewers to make it to the end of the video too. Number three, text. Initially, when I was scripting this video, I didn't think about text, but text has been in the beginning of every single viral video I've ever had. So that makes it important.
Did we add text for that?
Burp text.
And you watching at home can also achieve this by creating a title. I prefer using the T tool and selecting my preferred font. On my channel, I am pretty strict about using Gotham Black font. It is just my classic go-to font. To make this word-by-word text happen, I cut the title at the beginning of the word and at the beginning of the next word. And then I pretty much delete on the title itself. In the end, you get a nice fluid and aesthetic effect like this.
Number four, montages that serve a purpose. My biggest pet peeve is a montage that is too long, especially if the B-roll is mid, in other words, has no riz, is lame or shaky or not beautiful. Cut that shit out. Oh yeah. Sorry, I forgot, where, you know, this is for a premiere. Cut it out, all right? Let me explain how to make a great montage. Let me talk to a. First, I like to fade in the music before the first clip of the montage using this tool. Then, cut the visuals to the beat of the song. I look and extend the timeline vertically so I can see the peaks and valleys in the audio. I also love to use masks as a transition in my montages. I think it just adds a special touch. I do this by finding two clips, one where there's some type of full screen wipe that happens, like walking across the entire frame, and a clip I'd like to transition to. Ideally, my rule is to have it change to a scene or location that wasn't in the first clip, so there's more of a drastic change. I use my keyframes and mask the entire thing, click invert and adjust the feather, and make the entire mask 100% so the other clip can show. I then add a sound effect and you get this. Overall, my rules for a montage is variety of shots. I like to get a wide shot, a close-up shot, a medium shot, definitely capture moments with motion. That makes it way more cinematic. And in the end, you get a nice montage. Number five, emotional music and narration. To me, this is where great videos are made, in the sound department. Okay, let's stand for this. It's not just music, it's not just editing. This is about virality. You gotta speak from the heart. When you make a narration, you have to craft it, you have to believe it, you have to speak your truth. And when I was finding the song for the end of the world's shortest woman video, the banger that it is, I scoured the globe. I looked down, deep, high, low, until I found something that was powerful, something that gave you chills, gave you goosebumps. Then you paired it with the perfect narration, and you left the viewers off with something nice and sweet, nice and juicy, like a steak. All right, let me sit back down. Let me chill a little bit. Back to the actual tutorial.
Some tricks I like to use are low pass, which sounds like a muffle. I like to use this in between montages because you can hear talking clips better. And you can do this effect by dragging low pass onto any clip and adjusting to about 500, which is where I like it because it sounds really nice and muffly, but it depends on the music itself. Sometimes I have it higher, sometimes I have it lower. In addition to finding the right music and crafting the right narration, I do also think having a nice visual with it is really important. So doing simple color grading, like just dropping shadows, can really help bring out whatever emotion you're trying to tell. But back to the audio part. For narrations, my secret tip is that I like to add parametric equalizer, which is an effect, and then within parametric equalizer, I like to turn on vocal enhancer, which kind of makes your voice a little bit more crispy. On top of that, sometimes I add multiband compressor if I'm feeling really fancy, and I'll turn on broadcast, and that'll just sound like you're in a movie. And honestly, with those two effects, you're gonna have pristine audio and a pristine narration.
She might be the world's shortest woman, but she definitely has the world's biggest heart. She might be the world's shortest woman, but she definitely has the world's biggest heart.
Perfect audio achieved.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, you're filming. Well, just like editing, it's like a muscle. You have to try, put in the reps, and after watching this tutorial, you're a little bit step closer to making that viral video. So good luck. Thanks for watching and put in those reps. Bye.